Hey there, everyone. This is Michael Zugel, the Nootropic Reviewer. Should you or should you not supplement with taurine? It's a supplement that I've been on and off of over the past 5 years, and I'm going to share my experience, some new research, the actual dosage that is recommended to take, as well as the side effects. And I want to jump into this first study over here. And this was a fairly recent publication, Emergence of Taurine as a Therapeutic Agent for Neurological Disorders. And fortunately, they actually did conclude that supplementing with taurine could be helpful during the aging process, could be helpful with not only reducing the likelihood of seizures taking place, but also with a number of neurological disorders. So how could taurine supplementation be helpful for somebody like myself? Maybe somebody that isn't too concerned about slowing down the aging process, that just wants some sort of cognitive boost to help me be more productive. And that's debatable. I actually don't supplement with taurine anymore, and that's because of the fact that I really didn't notice too much of a benefit. You see, I like the fact that it's an amino acid. It's a naturally occurring supplement. There are some great amino acid nootropic supplements out there, like L-tyrosine or like L-theanine. With taurine, it's going to most often be used as a nootropic supplement to better help manage anxiety or even reduce levels of anxiety. It really only became popular as a nootropic supplement or fitness supplement within the past 5 years or so, specifically because of it being a common ingredient contained in energy drinks, specifically Red Bull. And there's actually a lot of people that believe taurine is one of the key ingredients that's necessary in energy drinks. And energy drinks usually have high amounts of caffeine. They usually have vitamin B, sometimes sugar, or of course you can opt for the sugar-free alternative, but taurine is believed to help to pretty much extend the energy releasing effects of caffeine, which sounds crazy, but from a practical experience in consuming a lot of these energy drinks or even adding taurine along with my caffeine, I do notice that I don't feel as bad of a caffeine crash as I typically do have. But taurine also, it kind of levels off the intensity that I get with caffeine. See, typically when we consume caffeine, we feel this euphoria come about, we feel very positive. I find with taurine, I'm still a bit level-headed, and that's okay, I guess, because our judgment is still good and it's not impaired, but sometimes I like that caffeine. It kind of puts me in that nice days. And a typical can of Red Bull will have about 1 gram of taurine, which is a good serving size, but you can still actually take quite a bit more than that. A lot of people take 3 to 4 grams of taurine every single day. There have been many days when I've gone taking like 4 grams of taurine and even taking it in a consistent fashion every day, and I noticed I liked it because I didn't have to cycle off it or anything. But at the end of the day, I was just questioning whether or not it was even useful for my nootropic stack. And I like that it has somewhat of a consistent effect versus other nootropic supplements that may help with anxiety. Sometimes I'll ingest them, I'll feel good. Sometimes I'll ingest them, I'll feel tired, or I'll feel motivated, or sometimes they can even increase my levels of anxiety to other levels. Taurine is one of the most abundant amino acids in the body, and it's almost found exclusively in meats and seafoods. So perhaps you can make the argument that supplementation may be a little bit more recommended if you're somebody that doesn't eat any meat or seafood. And how the name taurine came about was that German scientists actually discovered it in ox bile back in 1827, therefore naming it taurine, which is the Latin term for taurus. However, taurine is actually not used in the process of muscle protein synthesis like branched-chain amino acids are. More so, what it does is it actually helps to draw in water to the muscle cell. Therefore, you can make the argument that though taurine may not perhaps help you build muscle, it can indirectly help you to build muscle, because if it's drawing more water into the muscle cells, it may help with performance, help you with your cardio, help you to lift more, and then that, as a result, combined with progressive overload, is going to help one individual build more muscle. The other way in which it may help one with their body composition is by improving insulin sensitivity. So when your insulin sensitivity is higher, it's more likely that those calories which you consume are going to be consumed and going to be shuttled towards muscle cells versus fat cells. See, when you have low insulin sensitivity or insulin resistance, that's like when you're diabetic, what happens then is what you don't want to happen, and that's when you consume food, you actually feel tired instead of feeling energetic. Keep in mind, this isn't an on and off switch. You can be more insulin sensitive than the next person. You can also have lower insulin sensitivity levels, but also remember that as we age, we generally become less insulin sensitive, and we have to be more mindful about exercise and eating good nutrition. And this is a really neat study, the effects of an oral taurine dose in supplementation period on endurance exercise performance in humans. This is a meta-analysis, and what they had concluded, taurine ingestion improved overall endurance performance, and the doses did actually vary between 1 to 6 grams. But I do want to point out something from the earlier study, and you may actually experience better benefits if you consistently consume taurine, which poses the question, like, should you be taking taurine every single day, or should you be taking time off of it? And my guess would be, if you're using taurine for physical performance or for improving your body composition, it may not be so important that you're using it every single day. I think it just may be more practical if you use it on your workout days. Take a little bit of taurine before your workout. It may help with recovery. It may also help with, of course, increasing increasing hydration to the muscle cells like we talked about. However, if you're using taurine specifically as a nootropic supplement to help you with performance and with cognition, then it may be beneficial if you were to consume it every single day. I think a serving size of around like 1 to 2 grams first thing in the morning would be good. Though this is highly variable, I think for the majority of people, especially younger individuals from age like 20 to 40, you probably won't notice taurine really doing anything. That's been my experience as well. I did continue to use it for a prolonged period of time just because of the fact like it wasn't the most expensive nootropic in the world, which I enjoyed. I did believe that maybe it was sort of help with anxiety levels or energy levels, but it's one of those things that's just too hard to track and you have to have like really good levels of self-awareness to even notice anything. However, something I really do like about taurine is that the side effects are basically unknown. I haven't come across many. I didn't experience any side effects myself, and it seems like the list of benefits is only getting longer and longer every single year as we do find more research. For example, this recent study, taurine, a source and application for the relief of visual fatigue, they found that of what happens with our eyes, they get tired over time. As shown, according to reports, supplementation with appropriate doses of taurine may help to reduce visual fatigue. Imagine yourself, for example, going about your day and then needing to take a bit of a break, closing your eyes for a bit, and then getting back to work. Taurine can kind of act as a supplement that can do that itself. And then, of course, we have study after study after study showing just how effective taurine can be in the anti-aging process. As shown here, this was a recent study done as well. Taurine as a potential anti-aging therapy, the key to reversing the aging process. And it reads that taurine may strengthen your body's antioxidant defenses and reduce your risk of diabetes, high blood pressure, and cardiovascular disease. And the inclusion of taurine in the diet may provide a widely available, inexpensive, low-risk method of preventing aging with results that are better compared to currently available expensive anti-aging therapies. And there's actually even research that shows taurine may be helpful when it comes to chronic fatigue. So chronic fatigue, think of like an individual that wakes up tired, they suddenly get tired for no reason. Sometimes it's an iron deficiency, sometimes it's testosterone, it's thyroid. But many of the times this has actually happened because of low taurine levels, and individuals then supplemented with taurine and they no longer felt those symptoms of feeling chronic fatigue. But they were actually curious to know if there was some sort of correlation to taurine ingestion and longevity. And what they did was they did studies covering 61 populations and 25 different countries, and they did find that taurine ingestion was as well associated with a lower likelihood of stroke and a lower likelihood of a specific heart disease. And Japan is actually known for having one of the longest lifespans, and they are often eating squid, more seaweed, and more octopus than anywhere else in the world. These foods are super rich in taurine, so if you're not supplementing with it, you may benefit by, of course, consuming some foods which are rich in taurine. Let me know your thoughts about the supplement in the comments section below. And if you did find value from this video, do subscribe to this channel. I post weekly educational videos on different nootropic supplements. And if you want to chat with me one-on-one, you could message me on Patreon, and be sure to visit our Discord server. It has a 24/7 chat room. We're answering questions in a time-sensitive fashion. I thank you for your interest in nootropics, and I look forward to seeing you next time.